two testing each other out before a huge MCG crowd. The Magpies lost narrowly in the elimination final last year to the Saints, and despite going out in the first round of the Foster's Cup, are certain to be at their best tonight. Footscray made it to the preliminary final after finishing second on the ladder, and who'd be going to suggest once again the Bulldogs won't be barking come finals time. The AFL Today, as season 93 kicks off on Seven Sport. They certainly like winners out west, and as the Bulldogs, with a designated home side, they saw fit to wear out baseball champions, the Melbourne Monarchs. When Cuz strutted his stuff, the stage shook. They loved that as well. And despite rain at the MCG, the crowd adored it. James's number with Darryl Braithwaite was a superb warm-up for the fans and indeed their voices. Yes, it is the AFL Today, a blockbuster under lights to kick off the season, and two sides there that most expect to again figure in the September action. Footscray had Chris Grant, Tony Campbell and Brian Royal missing through injury. 18-year-old Rover Scott West came in for his first game, while the Magpies had also brought in a new Rover, if new is the right word there, in Barry Mitchell, the million-dollar man. The Woods struggled in their last practice match at Arden Street last week, but in round 14 last season, they beat the Bulldogs at the G by 6 points before nearly 68,000 fans. Our commentators tonight are Drew Morfitt, Ian Robertson and Don Scott, and we join the match with some highlights of an action-packed first quarter.
Francis accepts the pass. Collingwood really not all that much closer to goal. Starcevic, the kicker. Francis runs close to the man on the mark, who was Liberatore. A high kick to centre-half forward. No mark taken by Rocker. Oh, Williams must receive a free kick. And the crowd love it. The big crowd here, I'm sure, would be dominated by Collingwood fans, although Footscray, over the last 2 years. 50-metre penalty, is there? Yes. Tony Shaw, pretty happy with what's going on. Foster in the middle of the action. Well, it's going to give Collingwood certainly the first score and the first goal.
Mansfield, been prominent early. Centre halfback is wined. Mansfield going past for another possession. He's left-footed to centre half forward. Del Rey might have taken the mark once he got there. Atkins fires out a good hand pass. Here's Leon Cameron out of the centre square. Chance for Del Rey. Good kick. Distance will worry him. Still not, no advantage. Collingwood wanted him to be a goal-kicking little man. Now, will 55 metres be too much? He goes in short. Rocker, good mark!
He's fixed up a Footscray player in the process.
Actually, I was looking around for Scott Wine. He was down behind.
Leave that young fellow
alone.
That's
Mansfield, I think.
I think it might be Liberatore.
I think it might be Liberatore.
And he looks very limp.
Yes, it is Liberatore too.
He's in a bit of trouble, Tony. His body is so limp, this is what concerns me. As soon as one of his teammates tried to get him up, it was just like jelly.
He should kick this from about 30 metres. The crowd tells the story.
So well picked up by the umpire.
Hunter comes away for Footscray, kicks it high out towards right half forward. Good mark taken by Reynolds, who's come a long way down from the full back line. Player in support, Wallace, but Reynolds goes long towards the goal square. At the back, Hawkins.
Now he
may even bounce through. If that hasn't been touched, it's a goal. It's a goal to Footscray.
Kurt's long kick from the last line of defence to centre wing. Soccer forward by Foster. Kellett goes back to Cameron. Hunter. Kick by Hunter. Inside centre half forward. Punch by Gaper. Chance here. 48 metres out is McPherson. On the standing start. Kicks a goal.
Now that's... Is that Gary Kurt? Let's hope he's all right. He doesn't look too good either. He looks all right, Gary Kurt. He's up on his feet. He's not too flashy. He'll have to come off the ground too. There's Pert number four. Oh, knee I see. Up. It was the knee. The knee of Gaper. Boy, that would hurt.
Well, that could get you on a very dangerous spot and really put your lights out. Richardson.
Has been playing well in pre-season, Richardson.
Oh, shocking kick. Gee, Kellett. Hawkins been a bit quiet so far. Away to Collineau. He's kicked towards the forward pocket, Ballantyne. Can't mark. Collineau kept going. Blazes it long. One-on-one on the goal square. Well, pushed by Del Rey. No whistle. A chance off the ground. Smith. Rowan Smith, the goal scorer.
Good play, Del Rey. Fraser kicks towards left half forward. No mark taken. Crumbs gathered by McPherson. Foster. Now Francis. Just seconds left. Collingwood have to take a mark from this. Up towards the goal front. Rocker. Dacos gathers it beautifully. Away from McGuan. Kick it quick, son. There's only seconds left. Williams goes in and gets it. Right on the quarter-time siren, Paul Williams kicks his second goal.
So the Bulldogs leading by two goals at the first change, 5-4 to 3-4, two stretcher cases in the opening term. We pick up play early in the second quarter now. The Bulldogs have added just one behind.
Brown picked a play at full forward, now finds himself at fullback. Third off the ground. Christian in the middle. Cameron, gee, flew like Superman. Hunter. Ball bounces through to Smith. The hand pass in is good to Croft. He pops it over the defence. That was a wobbly old kick and out of bounds on the floor.
Bit of pressure on Croft then. Two Footscray Collingwood fellows running at him. He had to pull the kick, as you saw. Hence, over the boundary line on the floor.
McGaffer to take the kick. Crowd still hasn't built anywhere near to the expected 80,000 or so. We might have talked it up too much. Play hasn't let us down. Croft takes the mark into Wallace. Just gets the kick away in time, but not a great kick. Oh, Collingwood players fighting each other for the ball. Wright beats Russell, and the kick bounces out of bounds.
Got great recuperative powers, that man on screen, Glenn Coleman. He rolled an ankle. He was under a cloud. Takes a lot of courage to overcome an injury and playing in centre-half forward, the most difficult position on the ground to play.
What about the strength of the big man there? Scott Wine. Handball for Coleman. Now Collineau. Collineau's kick in towards the front of the goals. Del Rey can't take the mark. Richardson under a little bit of pressure. Falls over. Hawkins looking for the free kick. Taken by Croft. Mark Watson. Play on. Collingwood out of trouble. Francis gathers. He's at right half-back, running away from the 50-metre line. Taps it on the ground, then two bounces. Runs his full 15 metres, and then torpedo punt kicks it in towards full forward. Opportunity for Williams. Bounces, not bad. He could have nearly tapped it over for Dacos. Gathers.
There's a free kick for holding.
And it's going to Collingwood to be taken by Williams.
Against Mansfield.
Well, at quarter time, Collingwood had received 12 free kicks to Footscray's 5. And Footscray led on the scoreboard 5-4 to 3-4.
In that instance of play, Keenan Reynolds really should have gone the first time he made a move to go forward, which is just a bit later. Then he tried to collect Williams. Had he have gone his first time he thought about it, he would have got the ball.
Williams for his third goal. Williams kicks his third goal. Well, Paul Williams is the leading goal scorer on the ground, and Collingwood 4-4 trail Footscray 5-5.
Well, two of his goals have come from free kicks, a 50 metre, and that one there, you can see there McPherson holding. I wish the umpire would be consistent, because a lot of that holding goes on all over the ground. And the other one, he was on the end of a hand pass.
Footscray now by just 7 points. Wine wins in the middle. Cameron along the ground. Coleman beaten by Christian. Cameron again. Somehow gets boot to ball. One-hander by Collingwood.
I'll tell you what, Scott Wine is having a real influence at the centre bounces.
That was a good head out, wasn't it?
Oh, yeah. He's just so strong.
Well, he's got a better leap. What Monkhurst tried to do was jump a little early. He didn't judge it properly. Had he had jumped early and jumped into Wine, he might have negated him.
Collingwood kicked the winning goal against Collingwood here a couple of years ago on a Sunday afternoon. Who'll ever forget that? Doesn't live up to that tonight. Up behind.
He took about four opponents on that day, didn't he? It certainly was the goal of the day. Steve Collingwood, an exciting player, as Gavin Brown kicks into the far side. Monkhorst tries to tap it on. Cameron certainly doing well. Away to Wallace. Wallace's kick into the pocket. Ballantyne. Oh, that's holding, man, isn't it?
It's got to be a free kick. Yes, it is, too. The umpire's picked it.